Good evening. I'm Kevin Dorn, and this is Nightcast. We're living in tough times right now. The pandemic's created challenges people never saw coming. As the economy tanks, many lost their jobs and their homes. We've seen more homeless encampments popping up in the Twin Cities. Just this morning, Park Police cleared the PV Park encampment in Minneapolis because it was located in a safe school zone. The Parks and Rec Board tells us there are currently 15 permitted homeless encampments in city parks, but those permits could end next month. This comes as we head into winter and shelter space is limited. Hennepin County and local nonprofits have turned to hotels during the pandemic to help. Kellen Gray has an update on how it's going.
For hundreds of people experiencing homelessness during the pandemic, hotels have been a refuge.
I've experienced the hardships of being homeless.
Alan Touch moving into a Bloomington hotel with his girlfriend earlier this month after meeting an outreach worker at the Franklin Hiawatha encampment.
I've always learned to give people benefit of the doubt. But I was like, is this for real?
Their two-week stay has now been extended to October 1st.
It's been a wonderful experience being able to have a bed to sleep in, being able to shower, get a good night's sleep, and allows me to go back to work each and every day, Monday through Friday.
A union member, he's part of the team building the Red Lake Nation affordable housing complex on Cedar Avenue that he will move into next year. For now, this has provided a safe place to stay for the couple.
That to me is worth its weight in gold, because I worry about her a lot, you know, when I'm not there.
Touch says he's been working with the nonprofit Zakah, but it's an approach Hennepin County is taking as well.
Our commitment there really is, you know, we took this public health step to ensure that the very highest risk people didn't get sick, and to reduce the risk overall of anybody else getting sick by deconcentrating shelters.
David Hewitt is the director of the Office to End Homelessness in Hennepin County.
And it's been incredibly effective.
He says since March, they've sheltered more than 800 people at hotels who are considered high risk for contracting COVID, either older than 60 or have an underlying health condition. They have three hotels for those individuals, plus they've leased two other hotels for those experiencing COVID symptoms.
Where we are dealing with sick people, we lease the entire hotel.
He says more than 300 have stayed at those since the pandemic began.
It's critically important that we stay on this path.
There is absolutely the need for housing for people who are homeless, who are vulnerable, who are in a situation where they simply need that basic shelter.
But last week, Bloomington Mayor Tim Bussey and the City Council addressed concerns about safety at hotels serving as shelters.
There was a significant increase in calls in a number of our hotels.
City Council documents show increases at five hotels identified as shelters. At one, a 569% increase. At another, a 361% increase.
The calls ranged from robberies to break-ins in the neighborhoods around to drug use and nuisance and noise complaints. In some cases, the hotels were not properly staffed, whether it was the hotel themselves or, for example, Hennepin County or whatever social service agency was working wasn't necessarily staffed up correctly.
According to the City Council, two of the five hotels are leased by Hennepin County, and calls to those have since decreased. Another hotel is being used by St. Stephen's.
Our community, I mean, the folks that we serve want a safe space. It's hard for me to really comment on what is attributable to our clients or our guests, you know, our participants versus non-hotel guests at all, you know, visitors or potentially folks that are renting rooms on their own.
St. Stephen's Director of Outreach and Shelter, Michael Huffman, says they didn't lease the entire hotel, but they have been doing rounds to ensure safety.
We are working with the hotel. We're working with police. We have good contact, regular contact with all of those parties.
As they continue to see demand.
We have a wait list to get into the hotels for folks that are being triaged, upwards of 80 folks. We do an annual point in time count, and our last count showed at least 700 people in Hennepin County that are unsheltered and staying outside.
Is it feasible with the pandemic to bring all of the individuals who are unsheltered inside this winter?
I think the sheer scale of demand and what is available to bring people inside, I think that's extremely challenging.
Is there enough housing for these individuals?
Fundamentally, in our community, there is not enough housing for people with very low incomes. We estimate in Hennepin County there are about 74,000 households that are in the lowest category of income that we count, and only about 14,000 units of housing affordable at that level. So it's a 60,000 unit gap.
While Hewitt says not all will experience homelessness, for those that are,
everybody's going to be working really hard on a person-by-person basis to get folks to the safest place they can possibly be.
Now, the Bloomington mayor is calling for a regional effort to address homelessness in the metro and says the state should be addressing this. Hennepin County says it has not set a deadline for when its hotel program will end. Hewitt tells us there will be financial challenges this winter. Right now, he says they are dependent on CARES Act funding, which cuts off at the end of December. Funding constraints are why St. Stephen's says they are not expanding their hotel program right now.
Wow, Callan, the numbers are staggering. They really are. Okay, thanks for giving us a heads up of what's going on there.